Hey folks, welcome to Quantsapp and welcome back to another video. In this video, let's get our foundations right. Let's try to understand what are futures, what are options in one of the most simplest and one of the most practical ways. In this video, we will understand what affects our futures payoff, what affects our options payoff, and we will try to trade futures and options by keeping in mind what are the risks which are involved while we are trading in futures and options. So let's start this video by understanding what are futures contracts. Futures are derivative contracts which derive their value from the underlying asset, which obligates buyers to buy and sellers to sell the underlying asset at a predetermined price on a predetermined future date. Now let's understand what this thing means. Okay, so let's now break down the definition. So let's go to architect, create a custom strategy, let's say Reliance. Okay, so over here we can select futures. Now let's simple things first. B means buy, S means sell. So if you are buying a future contract of Reliance of 24th November expiry at 2617, what does that mean? So that means that you are obligated to buy Reliance's shares. So this is our underlying. At what price? At 2617. On what day? 24th of November 2022. Okay. How many shares of Reliance will you transact? How many shares of Reliance you will buy in this case? It is 250. So now what is this? This is the underlying. Reliance is our underlying. This is our predetermined date, 24th of November 2022. This is our predetermined price at which we are going to buy the shares of Reliance. Okay, if we would have sold the future contract, that would have been, we would have been obligated to sell the shares at 2670. Okay, so now what this entire thing together means is a future contract. That if you are buying this contract, you are obliged to buy Reliance's shares, 250 shares at 2670. But when? On 24th of November 2022. Not even a day after the expiry date, your contract is going to be valid. So whatever buying and selling of underlying shares, okay, exercising your contract, that happens only on 24th of November 2022. However, you can square off your contract, but you can't exercise your contract before the expiry date. Okay, so now let's understand how it looks like. Okay, so if you just look at this, this is a payoff that we have got, and then you would have, you will be thinking in mind how much money will you require to enter in this contract. So you would be thinking that you will require 250, which is lot size of Reliance, into the price you have bought Reliance at, let's say 2617. So you might be thinking that you will require 6,54,000 in order to enter in this contract, but the answer is no, because futures are promised, they are contract. Okay, you're not buying the actual shares on the day which you are creating a contract, but instead you're entering a contract. So in this scenario, you will be required to pay margin. Okay, a margin which is MTM, maximum possible unrealized loss gone by within a day. That is the margin you will require to pay, plus the maintenance margin required to maintain your mark to market. Assuming it is, let's say, 1.5 lakh in this case, it will differ from contract to contract, but typically it would be from 1.2 lakh to 2.5 lakh. Okay, so I am assuming a middle figure, let's say 1,50,000. So this is your capital which you need. Now let's understand what will happen if Reliance goes 100 points up from here. So for that, you can directly use this RTR, which will show you plus 100 points, plus 20, minus 20 points, on what level of Reliance, how much profit or loss you might make. So till expiry, if you see Reliance goes up by, you know, 100 points, okay, if it goes from 2,620 to 2,720, you will make a profit of what? 25,563. So let's say 25,500 for simplicity. And if you face a loss, okay, if Reliance drops down to, let's say, 100 points from here, you will make a loss of 24,438. So let's say 24,400. Okay. Now, if you just calculate the ROI, so what will be your ROI in this case? So your ROI will be 17%. So you are getting 17% ROI in this case if you are, you know, entering in this contract and if Reliance goes 100 points up. Okay. In this case. Now, let's move towards our other contract. Because when you are trading in futures, first thing you need to understand is the obligation. Okay, with futures, you are obliged. Okay, so you are obliged when you are entering in this contract. So first risk that we know is that it gives you an obligation. So now let's try to understand what are options, and at the end let's try to compare both of them so that we pick up the best instrument for our trading. So let's understand options. So what are options? Options are again a derivative contract which gives buyer a right but not an obligation to buy or sell the underlying shares at a predetermined price on a predetermined future date for which buyer pays a premium. You would think definition is almost the same. Yes, but there are two critical words in it. Right but not an obligation. Buyer pays a premium. Option buyer pays a premium. So let's understand this thing. So it is simple. So let's create a custom strategy once again. Let's say Reliance. Okay, so if I'm creating a contract in Reliance right now, so only difference is in predetermined price in futures, it was the price at which we bought or sold the contract. That was the fixed price. But over here, you have the choice to select the price at which you are going to buy or sell the shares. So in this case, let's say if you are selecting your strike price as 2600, that means you have the right to buy Reliance shares at 2600 on 24th of November, 250 shares. Again, the lot size exists here as well. But over here, you have got a right, but not an obligation. Now, what does that mean? Let's say right now Reliance is at 2621. If price drops to, let's say, 2400, okay, price gear 2400, tak, then you will not honor this contract, right? If you have to buy the shares, you can go ahead and buy directly at 2400 from the market, right? 24th November, if the price goes up to, goes down to 2400, you can directly go ahead and buy it at 2400. But if this price, okay, if Reliance's price on 24th of November, if it goes to 2800, now with this contract, you have a right to buy it at 2600. Okay. If it goes up, you will have the right to buy it at 2600. Now that gives you a comfort, right? The comfort is of, if you have to, you can, if you don't want to, you don't. Okay. So this comfort comes at a cost. Now that cost is called as premium. Okay. So this is the premium which you are required to pay when you are entering into a option contract. Okay. If you are buying this option, this premium is paid by the buyer. And if you are selling the option, this premium is received by the seller. So over here, the moment you click on add, so strike price is basically at what price you are going to buy or sell the shares. Okay. So what strike price you pick up, that is the price you will go ahead and buy or sell the shares. And by the way, call option gives you right to buy, put option gives you right to sell. So let's understand call option. Okay. Put option is basically over here, you are getting right to buy in call option, in put option, you are getting right to sell. So if you see the moment I'm moving my cursor, the prices are changing, the levels are changing. So these are showing you on what levels of Reliance, how much profit or loss you make. Okay, so the question is how much rupees will you require? How much capital will you require to enter in this contract? So it is the price that you bought were into the lot size. Okay, so 57.8 into 2600. That is the premium that you will require to enter in this contract. Okay, so now let's jot it down. So let's say options. Okay, so over here, you will require capital of approximately somewhere around how much it is. So you will need a capital of 14,475. So let's write down 14,500. Okay, now let's understand if Reliance goes 100 points up, what will be the scenario? And Reliance, if it goes down 100 points, what will be the scenario? So if you see, it is 15,400, okay, 15,400 over here, 15,400, and stop loss pay, how much you are losing? You are losing 14,400, okay, but in this case, okay, in this case, what is your ROI? So if you just look at your ROI, it is 100%, right? You are basically doubling, right? Your investment has doubled. You paid 14,500. Your profit was 15,400. 17% was it? How much? 106%. That is beauty of options. With the small amount you participated and you see your ROI, the return on investment, it has doubled. Now, what is the risk involved? So everybody would have entered into a contract of buying options, right? And everybody would have kept on buying them. But if you see, the problem over here is just check this black dotted curve over here. Okay, so I am, if you see the payoff over here, it tells us that if Reliance remains at 2619, if my day slider is at zero, it tells me that today EOD I will lose 278 rupees. But if I held it till expiry, I might end up losing 9550. Why? Because in options, there is also time value of money. So the time will also decay its premium. So if you just see, if I hold this till 10 days from here, and if Reliance remains exactly where it is, okay, so if Reliance remains exactly where it is, still I'm going to lose 4,390. Why? Because it is the time value of money which is taking away our option premium. So time versus buyer, okay, that option buyer will make a loss the moment the time is going against him. Now let's understand another things of another risks involved in futures and options. So first thing that we understood is over here your risk is obligation, here you don't have any obligation. Second risk is if you just look at this payoff curve, okay, so if we just look at this payoff curve of future, okay, which is long future, you see it keeps on going down and down. Let's say if I just decrease it to 2300, that means I want to analyze the graph till 2300. You see at 2300, how much your loss is? It is close to 80,000. Okay, it is close to 80,000. Similarly, if you just look at this payoff curve, okay, if you just look at this payoff curve, if I just decrease the lower bound to 2300 and if I just hit on save, then you see at this level, how much my maximum loss is? The premium that I have paid, right? So the premium that I have paid is the loss that maximum I would make in this particular scenario, right? So that is beauty of option buying, that it gives you a limited loss, but an unlimited profit. So if you just look at this payoff curve now, you will easily figure out that, okay, on the upside, it is exposed, which means on the upside, I will end up making a lot of profit. But on the downside, it is capped, which means I don't have an undefined loss in this strategy. But over here, even the upside is exposed, but most importantly, even the downside is exposed in the long future thing. Okay. Only thing that goes against option buyer is the time which is ticking away. More you hold that option, more premium is going to get decayed due to time. Okay. So another thing that comes very, very handy when you are trading in options is that IV also affects your option premiums. Okay. If the IV goes down, just focus on this. Okay, so let me make it zero once again. Okay, so let's say if we are at this level 2524, and let's say if you want to analyze this, okay, 5 days from here at 2524, you will make a loss of 13,024. Where at Reliance at 2524, you will make a loss of 13,000 rupees. But if the IV cools down, let's say by 26%, okay. At the same level, if you see your loss, it has increased, right? It has increased. It will keep on increasing as the IVs, they keep on collapsing. Why? Because the thing is, options are affected even by implied volatility as well. But if the IV go up, your payoff will get shifted. At the same level now, if you see IV, if it jumps up, you are going to make only a loss of 5,333. So that is the case with options. So options are affected by time. Okay, so options are affected by time, IV, and the underlying price. So if you want to buy options and if you want to trade options, these are the three things you need to be careful about. But futures, they are only affected by the underlying movement. Okay, so we have created video on implied volatility as well, so you can watch it to understand how exactly implied volatility works and how you can trade options, you know, using implied volatility as a component as well. But apart from that, I would say, yes, that was it from my side from this video. So to quickly summarize what we understood, what are futures, what are options, and what are the risks involved in trading futures and options. So stay tuned along with us and be a data-driven trader. Thank you.